Welcome to the June 21st, 2011 Frontline Reports podcast from Doctors Without Borders, Médecins Sans Frontières, or MSF. I'm Natasha Lua. Stranded in the desert in northeastern Kenya, surrounded by mile upon mile of ragged brush, thousands of people take cover under makeshift shelters under a burning sun. They have fled violence and insecurity in their homeland of Somalia, and are now headed for refugee camps near a town called Dadaab, 80 kilometres or 50 miles inside the Kenyan border. They are in dire need of help, but, as they will soon learn, the camps are already crowded far beyond their capacity, unable to take in new arrivals. Originally built to house 90,000 people, the camps, which are called Dagahali, Hagadera and Ifo, are now home to more than 350,000. Collectively, they form the largest refugee camp in the world. And yet newly arrived families can no longer get inside. Having already completed an extremely difficult journey, these Somalis, the majority of whom are women and children, will face weeks of uncertainty as they struggle to find shelter, food and clean water. Nina Arnold is MSF's outreach nurse supervisor in Dadaab.
They travel far, often by foot. Many report being attacked along the way by either people or animals. Maybe they're traveling with no provisions, no food. And so by the time they get here, many times family members are sick. They are actually living outside the official boundaries of the camp because there is no space for them inside the camp. However, there are new arrivals in the thousands also that have relatives or friends that live inside the camp, and so they come and they actually live inside the camp with their friends and relatives. It's a real strain for the existing refugees also.
Those living outside the borders of the camps often feel unwelcome, said Mohammed Dawood. Originally from Afghanistan, Mohammed Dawood is now MSF's field coordinator in Kenya.
The place is not recognized by the local community authority as a place for refugees to be. They are accused of being damaged to the environment of local community. They are constantly harassed by the landowners, by the community occupying the land.
We are finding that they are not as malnourished as we were expecting at first, but after a few weeks in this extension with waiting for food rations for many, many days, up to 12 days. Some people even report longer waits than that with no food. Their nutritional status for the children, even the adults, but especially the children, really is bad. And often we find, every time I go there, I find kids that I can refer to our nutrition programs.
As more and more people crowd the area around the camps, it becomes an even greater struggle to deliver essential services such as food, water and sanitation, as well as the schooling offered to children at the camps. For many, living conditions are deteriorating rapidly. Most of the new refugees arrive in poor health. In Somalia, the health system's in a state of near collapse, and the majority of people have been living without conventional medical care for years. Drought in that country has made the situation worse, and many people are in need of urgent medical attention. Inside and outside the camps, the outreach nurse supervisor, Nina Arnold, and her team seek out the people who need help. The sickest are driven straight to one of MSF's health posts or to the busy general hospital that MSF runs in Dagahali camp.
So, along with myself, I have a supervisor that works directly underneath me named Mohammed Isak, who is a qualified nurse with a lot of experience doing community nursing. And he and I, along with our 78 CHWs, the community health workers, we go out and spread the message on foot. We walk into the blocks, we talk to people, we go to their houses, we make home visits. The community health workers usually live in the blocks that they work in, and so these are their friends and neighbors, so they know everyone in their block. So they know if a mother is pregnant or if some child is malnourished and needs to be checked on. They have an idea of how many kids are in the area and who should be getting immunizations. And so it's really on the ground, these people in their own communities sharing health messages with with their neighbors. It's really nice.
The inpatient therapeutic feeding center for severely malnourished children with medical problems is so full that tents had to be set up in the hospital grounds. Then, in May 2011, a new 60-bed extension ward opened to accommodate them all. There are currently 80 malnourished children receiving inpatient care and a further 782 in the outpatient program. More than 7,000 families receive extra food in the supplementary feeding program to prevent malnutrition. As the number of new arrivals grows, says Mohammed Daoud, pressure on health services is mounting.
It has an impact on the number of our patients at the four health posts at the hospital. The second half of January, the hospital was full. At the health post, the doctors and clinical officers are examining high number of patients, and actually from 8,000 consultations per month, we are about 11,500 per month now.
With no end in sight to the conflict in Somalia, the number of new arrivals at Dadaab is surging. As of June, 44,000 new refugees have been registered this year. And by the end of 2011, some 450,000 people will be in need of shelter in the camps, according to the UNHCR, the UN's refugee agency. A planned extension to one of the camps, known as IFO 2, was supposed to have space for 40,000 refugees and to provide temporary shelter for some of the new arrivals. But IFO 2 has remained half-built and empty since a breakdown in negotiations between the Kenyan authorities and the UNHCR. Nina Arnold said that when MSF realised that issue wouldn't be resolved soon, MSF knew it had to expand its focus outside the official camps as well.
I think the main struggle we have with them is just spreading the knowledge that we're here. We provide free services, everything, ANC, immunizations, consultations, laboratory. We have a surgeon here. We have all of these services, and we want them to know that they're available for them. We even have transportation set up for them. We have what we call the mama taxi for pregnant women in labor. We have a rented car that will pick people and take them from the health post to the hospital. We have donkey carts in the self-settled area that are available for people who can't walk to the health post. So we have a lot of methods for people to get care. So now it's just making sure they all know it's available.
The situation in Somalia is not getting better. People are not willing to go back to Somalia, and yeah, there is a need for agencies to stay here and to continue the service for the refugees.
The people that are focused on the new extension, this self-settled area, we feel that it is a humanitarian emergency. These people are really living with just the bare minimum that a human, I think, can survive with, just very, very little water. No shelter, no food, or very little food. They have latrines now. We pushed for latrines. There are water points, but they're very far, and there's very few with really low water pressure. So to me and to other people that we've been discussing this with, I think it is a humanitarian emergency.
To find out more about MSF's work in Dadaab and in Somalia, go to msf.org and find the MSF website in your home country. Send any comments and questions for the podcast to msfpodcast@msf.org. MSF is an independent medical humanitarian aid organisation that delivers emergency assistance to people affected by wars, epidemics and natural or man-made disasters in more than 60 countries around the world.